I have made this Excel file with the help of which we can do the calculation for the rectangular coordinates in open traverse and also in a closed traverse. The Excel also helps us in preparing the plan of the coordinates. Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to teach you about the calculation of the rectangular coordinates with the help of Microsoft Excel. In previous two videos, I told you the procedure with the help of which we can calculate the rectangular coordinates manually by using the formulas of latitude and departure. But in this video, the same will be done with the help of Excel. And one more advantage we have in Excel is we can prepare the plan using the coordinates. Now, first of all, we have to prepare the table. Like first is line, then length, bearing, departure, latitude. After that, easting, northing. These easting and northing will actually be the coordinates of the respective points. And at the end, we have point. So let's say that the lines are AB, BC, CD, DE, EF. I think that's enough. Then we will be having the length and bearing of each of the line. Let's say that the length of the first line is 122. The length of BC line is, let's say, 134, 155, 165 and 145. Similarly, bearing 27, 35, 48, 57, 68 or so. Then we need to calculate the departure. For that, we need to use the formula of the departure. The formula for the departure is L sine theta, where the length of the line will be taken and that will be multiplied with the sine function. And here the sine function will use the angle in radians, so that we need to convert into the degrees. For that we need to multiply with pi over 180. Similarly, latitude is to be calculated using the formula L cos theta. So length multiplied by the cosine formula, again that will be converted into degree from radian. And once we have calculated the latitude and departure of one line, so for respective lines it can be calculated. We have a starting line as AB, so the starting point would be A, and let's say the coordinate of point A is 500 and 500. The coordinates of the respective points is required for B, C, D, E, F. So in order to calculate the coordinates of B point, we need to add the easting with the departure and northing with the latitude in order to calculate the coordinate of B point. Now, in order to calculate the rectangular coordinates for the respective points, latitude and departure of each of the line would be added with the previous northing and easting. That will give us the coordinates of the next point. Now, once we have got all the easting and northing of all points, select all the points, then go for insert, where we will be drawing the map. And here you can see we have just drawn the map of that line. We can change the values, like I just have changed the coordinates of A from 400 to 400, like 100 to 100, and also similarly we can change the bearing and so and so. So let's change the bearing of AB as 110, so we can see there is a direct change in the graph for the plan as well. Changing the bearing of BC like 135, so you can see there is a clearly change in the plan as well. Similar other changes you can also observe as soon as we are changing the value of bearings. Let's change the easting and northing of point A as that of the previous, that's 500 and 500, so that we can have all values as positive. We can extend our traverse for FG, GH, HI. Similarly, the length and the bearings are to be added here. And on changing of the length and bearing, you can see the latitude and departure of the lines have been calculated. Also, we can calculate the easting and northing of each other point by simply dragging it down, and ultimately that will be giving you the easting and northing of the respective points. And in order to incorporate in the graph, we need to reselect the data of the graph. So on reselecting the data, you can see there's a extension the traverse. We can again extend our traverse by adding more lines like IJ, JK, LM, NO, PQ. Similarly, adding length and bearing of each of these lines. Once we complete adding all the lengths and bearing, you can see the easting and northing of each of the point is calculating directly. Ultimately, this will give us the easting and northing of all the points. There's a slight mistake here. It will be LJK, then KL, LM, and MN. Again, using the reselecting the data, we can have the extension and the graph. Same is being shown here. One more thing we can add here that we can go in the plus sign, then data label, and then we will be having all the data near to the point where you can see here. It is on the right side now, where you can see easting and northing of each of the line is shown here. We can change their position as above, below, right, left, center, depending upon the requirement. We can change the data anytime we need. We can change the data for any particular points, like it is being shown here. I think this is a better view to show that this is on the left side and all the easting and northing values are being shown. So finally, this is the data. We have got the easting and northing of each of the line. Similarly, I have prepared this Excel sheet with the help of which we can do the same calculations. For light blue cells, we can change the data. However, every other cell is locked. If we are just changing the value of length and bearing, the easting and northing of the starting point, the different points, different lines, we can change them. But the formulas are fixed here. And you can see once I'm changing the value, you can see there is a change in the graph as well. This was for the open traverse. I have another file which is for the closed traverse. This is the one. So in this file, you can see when I'm changing the data, it's actually forming a closed traverse having 5 lines. The points are being shown here. The coordinates of the starting point is shown here. I can change the length and bearing. You can see there's a change in that graph as well. Whenever I'm changing the value, you can see there's a change in the graph.